How do lonely people get friends? Extroverts adopt them. Edit, I just woke up and saw this thread. Thank you all for the replies, the silver and the gold, kind strangers. You guys just made my day. In what context are you using lonely? Lonely like, I'm an introvert and I find it hard to talk to people so I don't have a lot of friends, or lonely like, I just moved from LA to Tallahassee and I don't know anybody here. What has worked for me in the past is to be on the lookout for exceptionally kind and outgoing people. Put yourself out there and try to start a conversation with them. Chances are, even if you're complete ass at making conversation, they'll understand you're trying and will help you out. Even if you don't become friends with them, you'll earn some great experience in talking to strangers, which is really the number one skill you need to find friends. Get among a group of people who are enjoying a common activity. Having things in common is the best chance of making friends, and doing things in common is a way to achieve that. I can't wait to find out. Edit, thank random lonely person, let's be friends. What if I don't know how to talk to people, social, like, I'm serious. Edit, thanks for all the advice. There's so many I can't say thanks to individually, so here's a thanks to all and in advance. By the way, I'm only 13. I see a lot of comments here that are like, just put yourself out there. Which is fine and all. I'm not that socially awkward and have a lot of acquaintances. But how do you get past the small talk phase to make long-lasting and deep friendships? Whenever I open up about myself, it usually isn't reciprocated, or I feel like I'm being emo and burdening someone. Or I feel like I'm prodding other people to open up about themselves when they don't want to. Clarification, thank you for all your kind responses and tips. When I say opening up, I really don't mean unloading my life's story on a person I've only known for a few months. It's pretty intuitive not to do that. These are people I could have known for years and seen on a daily basis in that time. I struggle with making that shift to a less platonic relationship. I could swear I do ask them lots of questions about themselves, and I think that's what makes me strong in the good small talk department. I can't even tell if I'm trying too hard or not hard enough. Also, is it a problem if I'm always the one making plans with people when I muster the guts to? I don't mind, but it sucks to not get invited. And I don't know how to infiltrate a friend group. Like, I feel like there's something seriously wrong with my personality. Edit, so reading these responses, I'm realizing that I might have some other issues I need to work on in order to be receptive to relationships. I have a pretty low self-esteem, I tend to blame myself and only myself for past, failed relationships, and I am hyper-aware of what I think others think of me. A thousand other things, I'm sure. Scrolling through Instagram and seeing groups of friends doing fun stuff together really gets me down, and I don't think it's because of jealousy. I'm disappointed in myself that I can't force people to like me. Which is so wrong on so many levels. 2. Fuck, thanks for my first gold. I'm literally crying. I know exactly how you feel. It is that voice in your head that whispers insecurities and anxieties, and ultimately convinces you that the person does not like you and that you are better off alone. It is so goddamn difficult to shake, and I am still trying to figure out how. I can never get past that beginner stage, like you said. I think what it is that as we age and experience life, we become more jaded and distrustful. We see the world for what it really is, a place filled with liars and deceit, but also happiness and honesty. The difficult part is distinguishing between the two and knowing when someone is actually sincere, and that they want to know more. Fear of rejection is a strong emotion and it guides with a rough hand. By looking for community groups in their area that have similar hobbies and joining them. X, like running, look for a running club, there's always one around. Step 1, find extrovert. Step 2, latch onto extrovert. Step 3, extrovert will inevitably adopt you. Edit, this comment is mostly a joke. Make sure you and extrovert have similar hobbies, interests, and don't rely on them to do everything in the friendship. Ask them if they're doing anything that weekend, invite them over if you want to do something, etc. All relationships, even friendships, go both ways. Not always true. Story time. I'd call myself more of an ambivert. I traveled abroad with a group during college. I knew two of the people going because they were in the same program as I was. One of these was definitely lonely. I say this because she said as much and still says as much on social media. When you travel with a group, you tend to get close really fast because you're spending all your time together doing things often usually outside of your comfort zone. This was certain no less true with our group. There were maybe 13 of us total. Maybe the fourth night in out of the 2 weeks total, four or five of us were hanging out in our hotel room, which was connected to a second bedroom where the bathroom was. I walked into the other room to get to the bathroom only to find, let's call her Anna, crying on the bed. I was surprised and asked her what was wrong. She confided that she was lonely and feeling really left out because we were all getting really close and hanging out, and she felt excluded. I assured her that there was no attempt to exclude her, and I was really sorry if she felt that way. We were all getting to know each other, and she was always welcome to come join in. We were all in this together after all. All she had to do was just that, come join. She seemed to feel better, so I gave her a hug, and told her I'd meet her in the other room after I used the restroom. Fast forward to the next few days, weeks, months. She turned into a stage 5 clinger. I was happy in the day or two after that I could tell she was making more of an effort to join into things, but she took it to an extreme I never expected. She'd constantly wait for me and follow me everywhere. We'd all be sharing stories on the bus, and she would pretend that she was there for certain things we knew she wasn't, to the point that there was more than one occasion she would say she had this interesting interaction that we knew for a fact wasn't her, but someone else in the group, WHO, would be sitting right there. Like, how could you think we wouldn't know that that wasn't you? She changed her profile picture to a picture of her and I on Facebook. When we had gotten back to the States, she started leaving class with me and following me to my next destination without an invite, making it awkward to the point that you felt like you had to. She'd hover over people as they were making plans in order to make the case that she was part of the plans, planning. It was the weirdest, most uncomfortable thing. So this is all to say, please do not latch on to an extrovert. Joining into things is very different than forcing your way into things. I'm retirement age, and I wish I knew the answer to this. I'm an Aspie as well, and it just complicates the hell out of things. I texted someone today, asking if I could text them tonight to chat. I know they got it, they check their phone constantly for new texts, they just never replied. Which hurts a lot. I think I just don't understand friendship. I don't feel close to anyone, and don't feel loved by anyone at all, anywhere in this life. If you get a good answer, please share. I've been at this a long time and I'm often lonely as hell. Edit, since I'm getting a good number of replies regarding my text to asking if my friend is up for chatting later, it's how we do things. This is my favorite person at work, I adore them, and we've been friends for years. But they have a busy life, and so we sometimes arrange to chat later by texting and asking in advance. Sort of like, hey, talk later? Edit 2, she did text me. To say she doesn't want me to text her anymore. I still don't know what I did, but right now my heart feels like a single-use plastic shopping bag filled with hurt and shit, slowing draining out through a hole in the bottom. I looked forward to seeing her every day. Her smile, her laughter could make the worst day brighter and better. And it's gone now. And I feel stupid. I don't take chances on friendship much anymore, and this is why. I find someone, we become friends, and then something like this happens. The kicker for me is that I believe that if you value people, then you actually ask them, hey, why did you do that? That really bothered me. But if you see the person a disposable, then you just end it, like she did today. I have learned nothing from being alive, apparently. I have grown older, but no wiser. First of all, be comfortable with being friends with yourself. You have to be able to live your life happily by yourself, do what you enjoy, try new things, smile, and be able to find your own company, something that makes you happy. Then while you live life, doing things, trying things, make sure you seem open to other people and approachable, smiling, posture, eye contacts, etc. Also strike conversation. It's not weird to overthink that, simple as, hi, what's the worst that will happen? They'll walk away. If talking hard, make sure what I said about being approachable is key. Most likely, if you meet someone doing something you enjoy or just doing regularly, they will also be interested and may have similar interest. So if a conversation happens, make sure it's not too forward and uncomfortable, but also make it so it doesn't seem like a passing conversation but more of a meaningful one. Really just be happy with yourself and create good vibe around you and don't fear others. Have a nice day and hope you smile. You don't. You just collect a whole bunch of hobbies and activities that keep you busy. Get a dog. The dog can be your friend. You can then go to places where dog walkers go and talk to other people with dogs. If the people don't want your company, it does not matter because you have a dog. My only friends I have are the ones that have been here from the start. All my friends I have made in the past year are normally gone in a month. Just punch someone, edit, thanks for the gold, my highest rated comment. By not, under any circumstance, admit or show you're lonely. It's hard. Loneliness is like a deep stench you can't get off that's only remedied by the very thing it repulses. Bait other lonely people with internet comments based on their interests. Check every day to check the bait and add to it as needed. Snag the food of a potential friend in trap. Take home. You now have a friend. Feed and water.